I was hoping you would walk through that door.
Well, this was our bar. In L.A., anyway.
I went ahead and ordered you a drink, Cosmo, right?
Oh, I don't drink those anymore.
Oh. Wow, really? That's all you drank when we were together. We'll get you something else.
No, right, it's okay. It's all right. I didn't come here to have a drink. I came because I want to help you. You said that you were starting to remember things, right?
Yeah, I mean, not everything, you know, just this place. I was here with you, right? 4 years ago.
Right. That's good. That's great. I mean, it's progress. It's your first step.
I know. It's my first little window in the last 4 years of my life. And I can't stop thinking about it. So, we were here, right? And we were happy.
We were.
And then something happened. What went wrong with us?
No, where do I start?
I'm serious, Kendall. What happened that night? What went down?
You really want to know how you broke my heart?
I broke your heart. I don't think so, Kendall, no.
Oh, yes, I know so, Ryan. I was here, too.
So, but then what happened? We had a big fight here in the bar? That's what ended our relationship?
Well, it didn't bury us, but it was definitely the beginning of the end. Let's sit. Okay. You came here to L.A. for business, for Cambius. You begged me to come with you. So we were supposed to meet here and have dinner. And I showed up, I was dressed to the nines, thought I looked completely hot.
I'm sure you did.
Yeah, I thought for sure we would have this great night of passion.
And I blew it somehow?
You brought Greenlee along.
What?
Not literally, but you may as well have. I mean, you couldn't stop talking about her.
But I was engaged to you.
Yeah, hello.
But I was in love with you. I loved you more than I've ever loved anybody else. And I was here and I went on and on about another woman?
Yeah, but not just any other woman, Ryan. Greenlee. My best friend, my soul sister. I mean, you know, with Greenlee and me, it's usually love or hate. And back then, we were strictly in hate.
So that's it. That is what did us in.
Kinda.
I'm really sorry.
It was my fault, too. I always felt like I was running this race with Greenlee. And I could never stop looking over my shoulder to see how close she was. I was so afraid that I was going to lose you. And then I did.
I don't understand something. I don't understand how I couldn't have fought harder to be with you.
You know, Greenlee, when she wants something, she usually winds up getting it.
I guess I just thought it was gonna be something sort of more dramatic.
Oh, okay, so breaking my heart wasn't dramatic enough for you?
No. I don't mean that. That's not what I mean. I just mean, why this place? Like, why would I remember this place if it wasn't some kind of like monumental moment or something?
It was monumental. This was where we started falling out of love. I mean, maybe it was your mind's subconscious way of trying to forget about me. And how did you even remember this or even think about it?
It happened after I slept with Annie.
As in, you slept with. Wow, Ryan, I don't get you.
Well, it didn't happen on a conscious level, you know? I just, you know, we were together and I was there, and then I brushed a lock of hair off of her forehead, and I flashed back to the moment of us being here together doing the same thing right here, like that.
So, you made love to Annie, but you remembered me.
It's not exactly how I'm... sleeping with Annie just, it happened, and it was nice. It was really nice. It was, but then afterwards is when I touched her forehead.
Okay, I got it. All right. I mean, is Annie okay with just being a distraction?
She doesn't know. She was asleep. That's when I flashed back to you. That's when I had the memory of you, and it was nice. It was a good memory. Like, it felt good, but then I got this feeling that maybe you were upset here.
Does Annie know you had this memory of me?
No. She doesn't even know I'm here.
Oh, what does she think?
She thinks that I remembered something about her.
Oh my God, Ryan.
Well, I didn't want to get her upset. I didn't want to hurt her feelings. She looked so hopeful.
Okay, all right. I'm sure she did. I mean, especially after you made love to her.
Now I feel like I'm back to square one.
Not really, you're not. I mean, this memory, this is a good thing. You're starting to remember us falling out of love.
Yeah, I mean, it's just one memory.
Okay, but that fight that we had, that was just one of Ryan and Kendall's greatest hits. Trust me, there are plenty more where that came from.
I gotta tell you, I think I'm a changed man. I think I've changed over all these years. I do. I think that if we were together now, I don't think I would let you go.
You don't know that, Ryan.
Yeah, I do. At least that's how I feel.
Okay, well, no matter how you feel, you do understand that nothing is ever going to happen with us ever again. You know that.
Probably. Yes.
Okay, good.
Can I ask you an inappropriate question?
Might as well.
You don't think that we could ever be together again? Is that because you're so in love with your husband, or because you already have something going on with Aiden?
What do you mean, me and Aiden?
I'm just saying, you guys look, you know, pretty chummy earlier tonight, that's all.
Oh, no, no, no. No, you don't get off the hook that easily. You were more than hinting at me having some big love affair with Aiden.
I told you that the question was going to be inappropriate, so...
So it's not funny. Aiden is my friend.
Really?
Yes, really. And I know that's hard for you, of all people, to believe. But like you said, you've changed. So have I.
Okay.
Okay. You know what? You're not going to remember this, but before you lost your memory, you and me, we had gotten to this really good place where we actually were friends.
Uh-huh.
We were!
And there was no attraction at all. I'm sorry, I cannot buy that. I'm sorry, that stuff just does not go away. It doesn't disappear.
Okay, if that were true, then you would still be wanting to sleep with all of Pine Valley, every single woman.
No, only you.
Ryan, listen, I hate that Zach assigned Aiden to guard duty. I hate it.
To protect you from me.
Okay, well, it actually turned out to be a good thing that he was there. Not because of you, but because something happened.
What something happened? Are you okay?
I'm fine, and it was handled.
Well, I'm sorry that Zach thought that he had to get security for me. And I'm sorry that I even brought up this whole thing about Aiden, all right? I'm sorry.
All right. But just so you know, Aiden, he's just doing his job, okay? We were just clowning around, acting like idiots, as we normally do in my hotel room. And there is nothing more between us. I love Zach.
I get it. I know you love Zach and you're loyal to Zach. Never do anything behind Zach's back. I get it. He's a very lucky guy.
Maybe. Maybe not so lucky.
Zach is not lucky to have you. What are you talking about?
Nothing. Nothing.
Okay, fine, because you know that's crazy.
Okay, Ryan.
Yeah.
You know me, and you know that I'm not exactly low maintenance, okay? Right? I'm pretty high maintenance, and Zach has to put up with a lot.
Well, I'm just gonna say that some things are worth the trouble.
Easy for you to say.
What do you mean easy for me to say? I was willing to take the leap, okay? You are worth it. Kendall and Zach knows that, all right? Are you sure you don't want a drink?
Okay, you know what? Yes, I'll have a drink.
Word.
I think, excuse me, could I have a Cosmo, please? Thank you.
Uh-huh. Should I read into that at all?
No, how about, I just wanted to have a Cosmo. They look good and they're pink.
out of everything that we talked about tonight, there is the one thing that I can't quite wrap my head around.
Oof, I'm afraid to ask.
How could I give you up for Greenlight?
Funny. I could never understand that either. I mean, never, ever.
Thank you.
That's
great.
Oh, we're back.
What do you think she would say if she heard me say that?
If Greenlee heard you say that, mm-hmm. I think she would take this drink and bam, between the eyes.
So, you and Zach were married on a ship.
Yep. We were on a ship under the stars, the waves crashing under us as we said our vows. Just us, no family. It was perfect.
Well, I'm glad. You deserve it. I mean, I wish I was the guy. What can you do? Since you went away,
I'm sorry. You're a good friend, Ryan.
Even though I want you in the worst possible way imaginable?
All right, that's my cue to leave. I need to go anyway because I think Aiden's gonna freak out if he sees that I'm gone.
Yeah, we don't want to put on an APB. Hmm. Thanks for having a drink with me.
Did it help?
Yeah, I think it did.
Okay, I have to go. I mean, I really need to go.
Yeah. You do need your beauty sleep, so you should get going.
Hey!
What? I've been doting on you all night. I figure I should balance it out a little bit.
I don't think so. You just think you're so funny, don't you?
Yeah, actually, I think I do. If I do, I'll get you a cab. Maybe I'll even walk you to your room.
I think you should walk me to the lobby.
I'll take what I can get.
Ooh! A man who is easily pleased. I like it.
I don't know about that.
Okay, come on, let's go.
All right. Let's go. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Ooh.